If your mechanic doesn't use this app, then maybe it's time to find a new mechanic. Maybe that's a bit harsh, but only a little bit. Once I show you what this app can do, you're going to want to have it. Or at the very least, you're going to want it to be used by the workshop that looks after your car, so that they can diagnose and fix vibrations the first time, rather than charge you for things that they replace unnecessarily. And if you are the owner of a workshop, then you are going to love being able to provide a report, an objective, scientific analysis of a car's vibration to hand to or to email to a customer so that they can authorize repairs with confidence. Hi, I'm Stephen and welcome to today's video, where I use a very clever smartphone app called NVH to help to get to the bottom of why my car has a nasty vibration that only happens at higher speeds. So we're going to test the NVH app out on the road, we're going to look at the results, and then we're going to follow the app's recommendations to either replace or repair what we need to, and then run the tests again to see what's different, for better or worse. I'm going to tell you now that this app ends up finding much more wrong than I expected. Already you have to be asking why I would possibly need an app to find a vibration at all. Surely seat of the pants troubleshooting works well enough. Well, it doesn't work as well as I'd like for a BMW, and it is the same for many other newer, well-built cars that have chassis bracing as well as good cabin isolation from noise, vibration and harshness. So it becomes more and more difficult to pinpoint the source of an annoying issue, as it is muted and shared by the whole car. So it's for this reason that I started a journey down the path of trying to find a high-tech solution for vibration issues. Although I was getting discouraged quite quickly, as the options I found were going to cost thousands of dollars, and I figured that this journey was probably going to end before it even got going. Fortunately, it was then that YouTube suggested a video from a few years ago about an iPhone app that can be used to diagnose vibration issues in cars and trucks, and what I saw looked to have enormous potential. And even better for me, the app also now has been released for Android. So this is where I am right now. If we go to the Google Play Store and search for NVH, then there it is, a few listings down. And it's the one made by Vibrate Software Inc, and it comes along with a price tag of $399. So it is by no means the world's cheapest app, but if it does what it says it does, then it is by far the most inexpensive vibration diagnostic system that I've come across, and could be considered very good value compared to going down a wrong path, wasting countless hours fixing something that isn't broken. The idea behind this app is that instead of using custom-made hardware and sensors, the NVH app makes use of the advanced vibration sensors that are already built into every smartphone. Sounds like a good plan, but how well do you think it'll work in practice? The first encouraging thing is that despite the price, this app gets an average rating of 4.8 stars. So that's a fantastic start. Let's check out this detailed review at the top, which sounds like it's from a workshop owner who discovers from information provided by the NVH app that one of his mechanics didn't quite finish the job correctly. Apparently didn't line up the two-piece drive shaft properly. I'll put this review up on the screen, hit pause and give it a read, as I think you'll agree it is quite an amazing testimonial. I'm really hoping for those kind of results on my car, so let's get this app into action. Once the app is installed, we'll open it up and then agree to the safety warning. If you are based in the USA, then there's a good chance that you can pick your vehicle straight from the list that is already included with the app. For my European spec BMW, I'm going to have to enter the details manually, but that isn't such a big deal. First thing to select is that it's a rear-wheel drive car, then enter the number of cylinders, then the rear differential ratio, which is 2.56 for my car. Next, we choose whether the front and rear tyres are the same size. At the moment, I have on my winter tyres, so they are all the same size, so in goes that information. Next, we enter all of the gear ratios. All done. And we'll save that for future use. When we hit start for the first time, there are a few permissions to give. And then it's time to jump in the car and get some analysis going on. For this first test, I've got the phone attached to the windshield, but I'll do it differently a bit later. So when we hit the big record button, there are three different screens of information that are captured, and using the magic of video editing, I can display them all for you at once, which wouldn't normally be possible. There is the vehicle view on the left, and any problem areas will flash red. In the center is my favorite, which is the live graph. It gives you a visual indication of whether the vibration is tire speed related, drive shaft or propeller shaft speed related, or finally, related to engine speed. And the right-hand screen is the raw data, with the actual frequencies and the amplitudes. Each category is also broken up into three subcategories, so you can get an idea of whether the vibration is first order, which means that it is probably being caused by an out-of-balance or out-of-round item, or whether the vibration is made up of two or three wobbles for every rotation. As this test proceeds, you can see we're getting a lot of T1 and T2 tire vibrations, and also some drive shaft vibrations, and there is even a flicker of an engine vibration as well, every now and again. When you've finished recording the test drive, you can now access a bunch more useful information. There are totals for each kind of vibration along with their intensity, and you can also choose to display the information in a report format, which I imagine would be incredibly valuable if you're on a workshop and want to show customers that you're doing some proper high-tech analysis. And now onto the diagnosis section, where the biggest issue is displayed along with a big button to help you fix it. And this is part of what makes this the world's best car diagnosis app. For every vibration variant, there is a comprehensive list of possible issues that could have caused it, as well as what you need to do to fix them. Outstanding. I have to also point out that the copyright message on every page shows a date from 1994. So this company has been chasing away bad vibrations for quite some time, and it shows in the depth of experience that is packed into every document. According to the app documentation, the correct approach when fixing a vibration issue is to correct the biggest issue first, and then to rerun the test and see what has changed. So for this T1 vibration that I've got, the most likely fix is to go and get my wheels balanced and my tires checked to make sure that they are still round. So let's get on with it. As I'm in the middle of a lockdown, I'm confined to the car, but I'm close enough to see that two tires are out by 20 grams, one is out by 15 grams, and the remaining front right tire had a perfect balance, but is looking suspiciously egg-shaped. The tire technician has indicated that there is some wheel damage, and that there could possibly be some tire damage as well. So we'll go and take a closer look. If we lift the car up and spin the tire, you can see that it is not spinning true. Let's get it off completely and take it to the workshop. The outside edge of the alloy seems to be spinning fine, but if we look underneath, it's a very different story. That is one wonky wheel. So I'll get a new one ordered. It should be here in a couple of days. For road test number two, I still have the damaged wheel on there, but we'll see if fixing the tire balance has changed the results at all. You'll notice that this coin holder in the console is the perfect size to lock my phone in place and also allows me to hit the start and stop button without taking my eyes off the road. Of course, the best idea is to have someone else looking after the phone, but when I ask for a volunteer to help me drive up and down the same road multiple times, for some reason everyone was quite busy all of a sudden. So let's look at the results. Well, the tire balancing has removed the first order vibrations, as I hoped it would, and the wonky wheel is almost certainly contributing to the second and third order vibrations. So that's not a big concern at the moment, as a new alloy wheel should be here tomorrow. What we have now, though, is a first order drive shaft vibration. So let's see what that's all about. Once we click on the How Do I Fix This button, we are presented with many pages of diagnostic help, which sets me on the right path to sorting this out. So it's time to get this drive shaft out and find out what's going on. There is a two-piece drive shaft in this car, and a quick inspection shows that the center rubber support bearing is quite deteriorated and needs to be replaced. So let's do it. It looks like the new wheel has arrived. Let's get it to the tire center and get it swapped over, and then back on the car. Test drive number 3. We now have no tire speed vibrations at all, and no drive shaft vibrations either. Absolutely fantastic. This app is doing exactly what it said it would. Perfect. There is a very minor first order engine vibration being found, but I'm not certain that I can even feel it from the driver's seat, so I'm not really worried. Once again, the NVH app provides an encyclopedia of suggestions on what to look for and how things could be fixed, if I ever feel the need. I'm pretty sure that by now you can see why I have described the NVH app as the world's best car diagnostic app. Even in the very first test drive I took with the app, it successfully identified the issues. I mistakenly thought that there was only going to be one tricky issue, but the app knew better, and identified instead 3 separate issues that were combining to make my car unpleasant to drive fast. It certainly helps to explain why I couldn't quite identify where the vibration was coming from, using the old seat-of-the-pants testing method. To sum up, I would say that if you want to move into the 21st century when it comes to finding vibrations in your car, then this is definitely the way to do it. I'll put a link to the NVH app down in the video description, and I will mention that I am not affiliated in any way with the makers of this app. And if you go and buy the app for yourself, then I don't make any money from it. I made this video because I feel that this app is one of the most helpful car-related products that exists. If you like this video, then please give it a like, and if you think there is something in it that a friend might like, then please share it with them. And if you want to help me make more videos like this, then please consider hitting that subscribe circle. Until next time.